I'm 42, which is kind of cool because it's like the answer to the universe and everything. So I've got that going for me for another couple months. But yeah, this next one, she says, I, a true story, wrote it when I was 15. Most of Australia I recorded when I was 18, 19, 20. But 18 and 19, I think, mostly. This one ended up a single on Stuff All the World Does. This one has legs. I'm trying to tune and talk at the same time, and I'm not good at it. I'll just tell you the story really quick. So there was this really bizarre time when I was 20, after I'd sort of gone out and sold the Australia CDs out of the back of my car and opened for everyone. And we were just on tour all the time. And finally caught the attention of some record labels. And that used to matter a lot. Still does a little bit, but it was a different time. And there was a lot of glitz and glamour, I guess, to the whole thing. And so I found myself suddenly at 20 being flown all over the country and being put up in these really cool hotels and with these corporate guys trying to impress me. And I was, I guess, thinking back, I was pretty cocky. I think it was just to cover up the fact that I had no idea what to say because I was so inexperienced at that kind of thing. Because I'm just a kid from Maine, or at least especially I was at the time. So fast forward, I did all these meetings, and most of the time I had a manager with me or a music lawyer or whatever, and I would just sort of sit there and look cool in the corner and thought I was the bee's knees. But I had a meeting, for whatever reason, it was last minute, and I was by myself, and I had a meeting in New York with Clive Davis. So I went into the skyscraper, went all the way up to the top. You know, it was like straight out of Succession or something. You know, that kind of vibe. And I got through the various levels of receptionists and whatever to his office, and there he was sitting there behind the desk. And he had all the lyrics for She Says in front of him, printed out. And I sort of sat down, and he looked at me, and his first question was, so, Howie, who's the third character in She Says? And I had no idea. So I just said, I don't know. What does it matter? You know. And then I think he kind of looked at me funny, and I realized that I had to make something up. So I made up what every musician says about every song that they don't know what it's about. I said, well, you know what? I don't want to ruin it. I want to leave it open to interpretation. Needless to say, it didn't end up sounding good. Put me on the spot like that, you know. I felt like there's some kind of test to see if I could handle it. Sorry, I keep feeling that I have like a bear in the cave. I feel bad because there's usually not people this close to me. Splash zone, I'll try not to sweat and fling it at you. Oh yeah, I have to play She Says now, don't I?
Okay. Yeah, play She Says.
All right. You guys can quiet down a little bit. That'd be great. Barely even hear myself. Side of a road, window open by candlelight. So how would you know? A cold winter on the shore, chills a dress she wore, it's on the floor, and it feels so warm. That's why I'm wondering why you had to tell me what's going on in your head, what's wrong. Come around to another time when you don't have to run.
And when she says she wants somebody else, hope you know she doesn't mean you. And when she breaks down and makes a sound, you never hear her the way I do. Yeah, yeah. Guess it's right now. While we're here, tell me why it's so funny that she's so funny when you're mad. Always so mad, so mad, and that's why I'm wondering why I had to tell. What's going on in your head? What's wrong? Come around to another time when you don't have to ruin. When she says she wants somebody else, hope you know she doesn't mean you. And when she breaks down and makes a sound, you never hear her the way I do. And when she says she wants someone to love, I hope you know she doesn't mean you. And when she breaks down and lets you down, I hope you know she doesn't mean to. Yeah.